very much, Cathaoirleach, and I very much welcome the opportunity to update this House on the ongoing situation relating to COVID-19 or the coronavirus. And I'd like to begin by sincerely thanking colleagues for what has been a real cross-party and cross-grouping cooperation. It's already been shown, and I want to today on the floor of this House commit that we'll continue to keep members of this House briefed, but more than briefed, that we'll hear from you, interact with you, and ensure your input is useful in that regard. And in the coming days, as the Taoiseach outlined in this House, I intend to put a structure in place to ensure that we can further strengthen that cross-party work, acknowledging the political interregnum that currently exists. This is, of course, a time of national and international challenge, and it does require us all to pull together. I know that currently in Ireland, a lot of people are worried. A lot of people are concerned. I know that parents particularly are receiving an awful lot of information, and sometimes it can be hard to distinguish between what's right, what's wrong, what's appropriate, and what is not. I also know that the issue of the coronavirus is subject to lots and lots of discussions, discussions among teachers in schools, discussion, I'm sure, among students in the playground, discussions around the dinner table and in the workplace. People are following social media, and at times they can be exposed to myths, to misinformation, to disinformation about the coronavirus. So I would strongly encourage all people to take their advice from their public health doctors, to listen to doctors and medical experts, to follow the HSE advice, and crucially to trust our public health doctors. They have one focus, one sole focus, and that is to contain this virus and protect our people. We will continue to provide all the information we can, and we're continuing to develop our communications material. It's also important to know that the vast majority of people who contract this virus will not need hospital care, but can be treated at home. And I think that's important, because sometimes people think that everybody who gets this virus will require hospitalisation. That's not the case. And it's also important to know that currently in Ireland, the likelihood of person-to-person transmission is low. These words of reassurance do not mean that we're not taking this extraordinarily seriously. Of course we are. And I continue to emphasise, though, that this is neither a time for panic, nor is it a time for complacency. I want to assure you that our approach to this challenge is and will remain both vigilant and proportionate. I'd like to reassure deputies of the considerable efforts being undertaken in my department, led by the Chief Medical Officer, Dr. Tony Houlihan, and by the HSE and its public health experts, to contain and respond to this serious public health threat and to mitigate the consequences across society. As you are aware, COVID-19 poses a very serious public health threat, not just here in Ireland, but across the world. I'd like to provide you with an update on the current situation nationally. Last Saturday, the 29th of February, the Health Protection Surveillance Centre was informed of the first confirmed case of COVID-19 in Ireland. A second case was notified on Tuesday last, the 3rd of March. Both of these cases are in the east of our country. As you will now be aware, last night, the Health Protection Surveillance Centre was informed of four new confirmed cases of COVID-19. These cases are in the west of the country. All of the identified cases who are receiving appropriate medical care were identified and tested in line with established protocols for the investigation of suspect cases of COVID-19. I can confirm that the confirmed cases in Ireland are all associated with travel from an affected area in northern Italy, rather than contact with another confirmed case. There is still no evidence of widespread or sustained community transmission in Ireland, as has been seen elsewhere in other countries. The HSE is working to identify contacts the patient may have had to provide them with information and advice on how to prevent further spread. None of the patients have been named publicly by the Department of Health or the HSE, nor ever will they be, in order to protect patient confidentiality. This is absolutely essential to ensure that members of the public can have confidence that their privacy will be protected should they wish to report any matters to our health service. And in fact, an effort to not protect this privacy, particularly on social media, has been rather disgusting and despicable. We need people to come forward, to actually, when they have the symptoms, to identify, to cooperate with our public health service. And anything that lessens trust or confidence in that is not helping in terms of containing this virus here or indeed globally. Deputies can be assured that the contact tracing protocols operated by the HSE are a proportionate and adequate response to responding to these matters. We've also been working very closely with the public health authorities in Northern Ireland in relation to all of these matters, and public health authorities have activated all appropriate contact tracing protocols. I signed the Infectious Diseases Amendment Regulations 2020 on Thursday, the 20th of February, in order to make provision for COVID-19 to be added to the list of notifiable diseases, so that doctors who are at the front line of our response to the virus will be obliged to notify the HSE when a case is suspected or diagnosed, and will be able to take appropriate action to respond to the very serious public health threat posed by the COVID-19 virus. There has been a notable increase, as colleagues will know, in the number of cases tested, from 90 to 397 in 1 week, but there has been no community transmission recorded yet. With regards to capacity in our health service, I want to inform the House that we have now approved an additional 20 intensive care unit beds. The Chief Executive of the Health Service outlined these today, and further plans are in place for more in this regard. The efforts to contain the virus are continuing, and I will reiterate the advice of the Chief Medical Officer that central to this is that everyone knows what to do in the event that they have symptoms. That's really the message we have to get out. The general public is advised to follow advice from the HSE and from the Health Protection Surveillance Centre. Turning to the international context, as deputies will be aware, on the 30th of January, the World Health Organization declared the outbreak of COVID-19, or coronavirus as it's known, originating in Wuhan in China, met the criteria for a public health emergency of international concern in accordance with provisions of the international health regulations. We are guided in our response to emerging international public health incidences. Ireland follows the advice and the protocols of the World Health Organization and the European Centre for Disease Prevention and Control. As the situation evolves, we continue to work with our international partners, including the WHO and the ECDC, the other member states of the European Union, and the United Kingdom and Northern Ireland. I will be attending a meeting in Brussels tomorrow, where health ministers of the EU will have a further opportunity to take stock of the current situation and measures already taken in order to find the best approach for a coordinated response to the current spread of COVID-19 in the EU. And we need that coordinated European and global response. In line with our national emergency management structures, the National Public Health Emergency Team, chaired by the Chief Medical Officer, has been meeting on a regular basis in relation to the COVID-19 outbreak. The team is the forum for managing the interface between the Department of Health and the Health Service Executive during the planning and response phases of a public health emergency such as that which we now face. As part of its continuous assessment of Ireland's response and preparedness to COVID-19, the National Public Health Emergency Team, at its meeting on the 3rd of March, recommended a number of further measures, which include an update to the travel advice for Italy to advise against all non-essential travel to the regions of Lombardy, Veneto, Emilia-Romagna and Piedmont. Mass gathering guidelines to be published in the coming days following a meeting of our stakeholders forum tomorrow. The HSE now moving to a community testing model for assessment and investigation of suspect cases so that everything doesn't need to be done in a hospital setting. And very importantly, 4 subgroups being established to support and provide advice in the following areas: for vulnerable people with underlying health conditions or older people, for health and social care workers, for our acute hospital preparedness, and for continuity of supply of medicines and medical devices. And I'm particularly pleased to inform the House that a meeting with patient advocacy groups will take place in my department tomorrow. An expert advisory group provides scientific advice and assistance to the National Public Health Emergency Team in carrying out its work. We're acutely aware that while there are significant health consequences posed by the COVID-19 virus, this also impacts more widely on society, and it poses threats to the functioning of our economy, to the functioning of our country. Issues such as port health, travel advice, contingency planning, communications, as well as advice and guidance to various sectors, including the public, have been discussed and are being kept under constant review. In response to this, the Government has now established a new Cabinet Committee, chaired by the Taoiseach, to assess the social and economic impacts of the potential spread of COVID-19. The work of the Cabinet Committee will include addressing the impacts and mitigation measures and contingencies for cross-sectoral issues which arise beyond just the health service, building on the effective public health work undertaken to date. A whole-of-government approach to the coronavirus response requires cohesive decision-making, a partnership approach, expert public health advice and clarity of communications. The Government also endorsed the establishment of a stakeholder forum, and this forum is the mechanism through which engagement with civil society, employers, social partners, local leaders, voluntary groups and others will be progressed and will ensure that they are kept informed of developments, what assistance they can provide and raise awareness of the appropriate responses to the challenges posed by COVID-19. Very briefly, I'd also like to take the opportunity to inform the House of a few issues arising beyond the health sector. In doing so, it's worth pointing out that the websites of government departments and agencies are being updated on a regular basis as the situation evolves. For anyone considering travel to other countries, the website of the Department of Foreign Affairs provides travel advice, which is updated as the need arises. The government is monitoring the situation with our agencies, ports and airports. Airports and seaports are following the advice of the National Public Health Emergency Team and are in continuous direct liaison with the HSE through the Port Health Group. The Government is mindful that any sustained period of significant flight restrictions would lead to very significant impact on tourism and businesses, and is keeping in regular contact with tourism industry leaders. Ministers Ross and Griffin convened a meeting of their COVID-19 Tourism Monitoring Group on the 26th of February to monitor the disruption to the sector, and this group met again this week and will meet weekly as necessary. The department, I'm sharing with the Taoiseach, I believe, the Department of Transport, Tourism and Sport has also been in contact with public transport operators, and a meeting was organised between the National Transport Authority, transport operators and the HSE on the 3rd of March. From a business, trade and labour perspective, the outbreak of COVID-19 is already having an impact. As you know, the Taoiseach has announced today the recognition of government that employees who need to self-isolate in accordance with medical advice should receive income support. We know this will require flexibility and responsiveness by employers and in government social protection schemes. Following consultation with employers and trade union representatives, proposals will be considered by the Cabinet Committee on Monday. Minister Humphreys and the Department of Business, Enterprise and Innovation are working on a range of supports and providing inputs across a number of areas impinging on Irish business, for example in relation to supply chains. The Department and Development Agencies Enterprise Ireland and IDA Ireland and our local enterprise offices are actively assessing and working with impacted firms, both in overseas markets and in manufacturing businesses here at home. Minister Humphreys' department has updated advice to businesses on continuity planning, which includes a practical checklist, which I draw businesses' attention to, as well as links to relevant COVID-19 advice. This, in turn, is being shared by business representative bodies with their members and would help companies to assess risk and consider preparatory actions to respond. Additional engagement with business representative bodies, including the retail and grocery sector, is ongoing. The Department of Education and Skills and Minister McHugh has published a range of useful information, including posters, guidance documents and videos, all of which are available on its website. I realise I've only been able to touch, in the time available, on a brief range of activity happening right across government, but I would urge all those interested to check the websites of our government departments and our agencies for comprehensive, up-to-date information. We'll continue to push out those messages through the stakeholder forum. But in conclusion, Cathaoirleach, Ireland remains in containment phase. As you know, the Chief Medical Officer will update the public, and indeed this House and the media, every evening as to the current situation. I think that's a really appropriate forum to have in place so people of Ireland get to hear from our Chief Medical Officer on a daily basis. Our current focus is on identifying and isolating any possible cases and ensuring rigorous infection prevention and control and contact tracing procedures are in place. However, the absolute truth is that circumstances are constantly evolving. We are learning more about this virus day by day and sometimes hour by hour. I understand just how anxious and concerned people are about this outbreak, but it's important to reiterate that if you're not in an area where COVID-19 is spreading, or have not travelled from an area where COVID-19 is spreading, or have not been in contact with an infected patient, the risk of infection is low. We will continue to communicate key public health messages to keep people informed and up to date in relation to all matters. There is very good information available on the HSE website about simple measures that we can all take to help protect ourselves, our families, people in our workplace, and to minimise the spread of a virus. And I'd urge everybody, including those of us in here, to lead by example in familiarising ourselves with that available advice. Finally, and I trust the deputies here will join me today in paying tribute to our health service personnel, our doctors, our nurses, our ambulance staff, our paramedics, our care workers, and all of those working on the frontline response to COVID-19. These people are working flat out and have been for a significant period of time, and we need to acknowledge that. I hope the information I've set out here this evening will be helpful in understanding the utmost seriousness with which government is treating this situation, and obviously our willingness, desire and requirement to work with the Oireachtas in that regard. I'd urge all of us at this time to recognise the potential severity of this moment for our country, and the need to ensure that we all act in support of our public health officials in their work. This is a public health emergency. Our response to that emergency can only be guided by the best international evidence and advice available. I'd therefore again like to thank all deputies of this House here today for working with us, for working together, for working collaboratively, as we focus our efforts on the immediate future of minimising the impacts of our country and our society. I very much appreciate the support of all as we work hard to balance the continuation of everyday activities with simultaneously taking all appropriate public health measures to limit the spread and the impact of the virus. Although we may not yet have a new government since the recent election, we do have a new Dáil, the 33rd Dáil. And I hope I speak for all members of this House when I say to the people of Ireland that whether you're in government or currently in opposition, we are united in doing our utmost to protect our country in the face of this threat. Thank you, Mr.
Thanks.